The image on your screen came up for a word search for Christ's light, because somebody in the group is generating Christ's light. But I'm using it because it could mean Metatron. It could mean Christ. It could mean the jewel of the heart. It could mean the Merkaba. This is one of those ubiquitous symbols drawn by an artist that could really represent a lot of different things and dimensions of our being. So, regardless of what you are generating, whether it be a quality or a named being, I think that we can all find resonance with the idea of the design of our quality, the design. That is to say, compassion has a design. The design is that everything be made better, that everyone be happy lastingly, that everyone be liberated from their suffering. So that's the design of compassion. One could say that the design of wisdom is supreme clarity, transparency, that we all perceive correctly. And that would all be relatively understood as well as ultimately understood. So we can all perceive more correctly any given moment. Just like with compassion, we all can certainly bring about the happiness of others and relieve the suffering of the world in whatever measure that each of us can. So we smile and take a long, slow, deep breath as we, look at this image one more time before we close our eyes and see the design of it. Granted, it's an artist's rendition, but artists have quite often such an intuitive grasp or an intuitive link to various qualities of reality. And so we look at this one more time. And whoever you are generating, or whatever quality you are generating, consider it as a design put forward by that being or quality. And then feel this design at the center of your heart. Keep your eyes open if you need to, but feel that deep white center at the center of your heart, and that your whole being is radiating like this. And then settle into that, breathing in and breathing out. And let us consider compassion pouring out from our heart, linking beings and their needs with our capacity to meet them, as well as with the capacity of others to meet those needs. So, like the image starts with lines, linked lines are connecting. Let us create that first. And let us imagine that every need that is met, no matter what it is, creates a little plexus of light, a little point of radiance. And so by doing this, we start to create this lattice, this design of compassion and its wisdom. And then let us envision and hold at our heart first the beginnings of a Star of David, a triangle above and a triangle below, interconnected, overlapping at the deep center of the heart. And so that which is above and transcendent and potential, and that which is below, manifesting, expressing, that they unite, and the possibilities and the potentials and the limitless capacity of each and every one of us and of all beings, that unites inside our heart. And then let us perceive these great triangles of divine and feminine and masculine capacity and potential. Let us see them expand and expand and replicate and replicate, such that we end up with the Sri Yantra at our heart, emanating out golden radiance of potency and potential. And if you have a mantra that you're working with, begin to recite the mantra as that Sri Yantra radiates, stabilizes, and is held at your heart. May we all experience the union of bliss and emptiness of compassion and wisdom in their most transcendent and sublime presentations and expressions. The lines of connection would represent compassion and thus represent the great bliss of experiencing the liberation and freed state of pure awareness and thus of all beings. And the space between all the lines and the golden auric field would represent emptiness and the wisdom that perceives all reality. These potencies pour out their potential in ripples and layers. And as they pour out, they create dimensions and realities and the possibilities that we all will meet every moment. And in the image that would represent the purplish zone of circular emanations, all still emanating from the heart. And that is because in truth, the heart is the only reality. It's compassion, it's wisdom, it's transcendent qualities. And therefore the truth of being. And we find ourselves pure radiance, pure transcendent being. And we find ourselves and discover that the field of our being, the field of expression, is absolutely inseparable from beingness itself. And that it is, yes, an expression, but it is not distinct or different from beingness expressing. And so in that way, the statement of the Buddha and the Buddha field are one, are inseparable. And similarly so, no matter what we are experiencing ourselves as, it is inseparable, our manifestation, our expression, and our quality of being. We radiate. And once again, if you have a mantra that you're working with, or a word that you're holding as forefront, then repeat it a few times again. Deepen into that, because the radiance and the field and pure being are that quality. They are that mantra and its meaning. And so we abide for just one more minute in the design of pure power, true power, that of compassion and wisdom. And let us feel all existence held within this matrix of pure power. We take a long, slow, deep breath to complete our sitting. Yet don't stop radiating the qualities of pure being into the world, because, of course, we are this being. We are this purity. We are these qualities. And so we don't want to turn them off like a switch and kind of assume our common daily expression, unless that daily expression is pure being. We want to keep it forefront and generate it. That's why we're in generation stage. And we seal that intention with our ohms. Love you all. Create not only your day, but the excellence of every day from wisdom, compassion, and their power.